Good morning, Fords, and happy Wednesday. I'm Matt Cleaver.
And I'm Maya Cantorino. Welcome back to another edition of H Vision. But before we get started, let's take a moment for the Pledge of Allegiance. Everyone, please rise.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. And now, Hurricane Harrison with today's weather.
Good morning, H Vision. Happy Wednesday. I hope you're all ready for this winter weather because we are fully in the thick of it now. The good news is there's only 7 days until winter break. Today we have a high of 45 and a low of 27, but the sun is out. It should stay out all day. So have a great one and we'll see you next time.
Thanks again, Hurricane. Now let's get to the announcements.
During second block today, all 10th graders will be expected to be in the auditorium for a presentation on the amazing opportunities of dual enrollment at DCIU Technical School.
Girls basketball won an amazing game last night, 60-26 over Upper Derby. Last night with Natalie Wright, Ryan Dotsey, and Ashley Wright all scoring.
Bowling club has started. All that are interested can grab a permission slip for Miss Greenswald in room 115.
The Mass Center is open Tuesday and Thursday every week from 2:30 to 3:30 in room 337 for all that need a little extra help.
Art club will meet every Tuesday after school in rooms 120 and 122 until 3:30.
The fitness center will be open lifts Tuesday and Thursday after school.
Today's Rainbow Alliance will be meeting in the library after school. All are welcome.
Today, guitar club will be meeting in room 129 at 2:30. See Mr. Olhaus for more.
On Thursday the 14th at 6:30, a representative from PHEAA will provide an overview of the financial aid process and available resources for Haverford students and families.
Asian Students Association will be having a boba tea fundraiser on 1214 in the East Commons. Go show your support.
And Rags to Riches will be having a bake sale fundraiser on the 15th by the gym lobby.
And now that that's out of the way, time for the features.
First, we have a teacher interview with the renowned Mr. Howe. Let's see what he has to say.
Hi, I'm Maya. Today I'm here with Mr. Howe, and we're going to be doing an interview. So our first question is, what is your life like outside of school, like pets, hobbies, stuff like that?
So I'm married. My wife and I live in Havertown. We have a son in fifth grade at Chatham Park, and we have two dogs. So even with just one kid, life's very busy. I like to fish. I don't get to do that as often as I like. And I really enjoy just being outside, trying to enjoy fresh air.
What was your first ever job?
So my first ever job, I was a ground maintenance engineer. So someone would drop us off at an office park and my coworker and I would pick up trash.
How would you describe your perfect day?
It would be waking up early with my family, of course, including my parents and my sister and her family in Avalon. Wouldn't have to be Avalon, but the Jersey Shore, going fishing and enjoying a seafood meal together.
If you could take a week off from your regular life to try something new, what would you do?
Oh, wow. I think I would love to, I would love to take a week and learn more about anything bug related from actual bug professors.
What's one fashion trend right now? It could be something that's coming back, but that you don't like.
Again, I'm gonna sound like such a Haverford teacher. The hood, I don't get the hood.
If you could visit any country in the world, where would it be?
My wife and I have been to Ethiopia twice, and our son was born in Ethiopia, so I really want to go back to Ethiopia and spend a lot of time back there and getting to visit more of the country and see more of the wildlife. And of course, doing that with my wife and my son.
What was your first car?
It was actually my sister went off to college and it was her car. So I kind of inherited it, although she really always said it was her car. It was a red Nissan Sentra.
We heard that you like to fish.
Yes.
What is your favorite or most beautiful thing you've seen in nature?
First was my dad and I were fishing in Canada and a family of otters came around a corner And they didn't expect to see us, and they saw us. And what was incredible was, is that the father was watching us the whole time, and like kind of like keeping an eye on us, like, I see you, while the mom and the babies like swam as fast as they could to try and get away from us. And that was just like, I hope I never forget that.
Yeah.
And then the other thing, I was in Costa Rica with a group of students, and we were hoping to find it, and we did. One night we came across a massive green sea turtle, and she was laying her eggs. And we were able to get close enough where we could, like, literally we were getting hit by the sand as she was covering her nest.
What's a movie that you can practically quote from start to finish?
The original Karate Kid.
Then for a last question, do you think something specific inspired you to be a teacher?
I had some really great teachers along the way, and I don't even know, it's terrible, I don't even know if he's alive anymore, but I had a wonderful science teacher when I was in middle school, Mr. Young, and he was just so enthusiastic about science and nature that he was a huge inspiration. And then I had another teacher, he was social studies, but he was just one of those really charismatic, engaging, positive, affirming teachers, Tom Namick. And the way that he interacted with students and the way he interacted with the other people in the building, he was a big inspiration.
Thank you so much for watching. I never knew that about Mr. Howe, but now a review on The Hunger Games: Catching Fire.
Hello, Fords. This is Carla Montre.
And this is John McGarry. Today, we're going to be reviewing Hunger Games: Catching Fire.
This is the 75th year of the Hunger Games. The tributes are to be reaped from the existing pool of victors.
After arriving safely home from their unexpected victory in the 74th annual Hunger Games, Katniss Everdeen, played by Jennifer Lawrence, and Peeta Mellark, played by Josh Hutcherson, discover that they must do a quick turnaround and begin a victor's tour. As she and Peeta travel throughout the districts, Katniss senses a rebellion is stirring. However, President Snow, played by Donald Sutherland, proves that he's very much still in control when the world comes of a cruel change in the rules of the upcoming 75th Hunger Games.
Directed by Francis Lawrence and adapted from Catching Fire, written by Suzanne Collins, this sequel was released on November 20th, 2013, with its box office total coming up to $865 million. This movie lives with a 90% rating on Rotten Tomatoes and a 7.5 on IMDb.
I think these games are going to be different.
The 75th Hunger Games!
Ready to work?
There she is, Captain 17!
The girl on fire!
I personally found the cinematography captivating. The light work used in contrast to the angles made for a dark, gloomy experience for the challenges of the characters. The scenes and CGI worked incredibly well together, drawing you into the world of the Hunger Games. You can truly appreciate the acting of Josh Hutcherson, Jennifer Lawrence, and the rest of the astounding ensemble. I give this movie a 9 out of 10 overall.
The element that stood out to me was the soundtrack. It's a deeply stressful and nerve-wracking movie with plot twists and threats occurring at like any given moment. So to highlight these scenes and events, we can listen to the music played in the background with harsh beats and jumps from silence to full volume. It highlights the movie's genuine desire to bring the audience into the scenes. And I can honestly say that this movie wouldn't have the same effect or tone without these specific pieces of music.
The cast in this movie is a factor that really makes it such a well-loved film. From stars we know, such as Jennifer Lawrence, Woody Harrelson, Elizabeth Banks, Lenny Kravitz, and Stanley Tucci, this movie brings that Hollywood talent we love to see in a different and unconventional plot. These series also introduced the audience to incredibly talented actors, like Josh Hutcherson, Sam Claflin, Jenna Malone, and Liam Hemsworth. Producing a movie with such a talented cast and placing them into a new and different project shows the real range these stars can bring.
I personally enjoyed the lore of the movie and how it fits into the series. It's usually hard for a franchise to remain this interesting, but The Hunger Games continued to intrigue me. And I love the world it built around the characters and the use of the futuristic technology prevalent throughout the movie, and I think that just justifies my 8 out of 10 rating.
I read The Hunger Games growing up and fell in love with the series, so being able to revisit the nostalgic and special story is the reason I enjoy this movie so much. I have so much admiration for the series as a whole, but the specific movie is my favorite. From the sudden change in the plot to the cast chemistry for one another, every scene is memorable and impactful for me. Getting to relive the books in a page-to-screen accurate adaptation contributes to my high rating of 9 out of 10.
This concludes our Hunger Games Catching Fire review. Thank you for listening, Fords. And may the odds be ever in your favor.
That was a throwback. I guess I'll have to check it out.
Finally, although we all know WAWA, I bet you haven't heard of some of its history. Let's go check it out.
Today we're going to talk about WAWA, one of the most preferred and popular shops in the US. I know that a lot of you guys love WAWA, but do you guys know its history? Let's go and check it out.
The WAWA dairy produced and delivered certified WAWA milk to the doorsteps of homes throughout the Philadelphia region. Its milk and cream products were of the highest quality and received the highest accolades from physicians and consumers.
The first WAWA food market opened on April 16, 1964, in Folsom, PA. Then by 1969, WAWA was opened in New Jersey and Delaware, where they started offering food like fried chickens, and then by 1972, more foods were introduced. By 1980s, WAWA won the Best of Philly Award for Coffee and Deli Department. WAWA started to become the land of everything by 1990s when it started installing ATMs, separating deli department, and offering more and more foods.
WAWA started its development even more after 2000 when they introduced their famous touchscreen ordering in all stores. Later in 2010, they opened their first store in Florida and a lot of fuel stores in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Florida, and later in 2016, they partnered with Tesla to install Tesla supercharger stations at select stores. In 2018, WAWA opened its largest store nationwide to date at Independence Mall in Philadelphia. In 2017, WAWA is still bringing new things for everyone that enjoys going there, like the WAWA burger, WAWA pizza, and other items arriving on the scene for the first time.
Some fun facts about WAWA that you may not know are that WAWA is now in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, Virginia, and Florida. Also, WAWA is another word for water. It has a Native American word for the Canadian goose, found in the Delaware Valley more than 100 years ago. It took 11 years for WAWA to start brewing and selling coffee. Also, the first cup of coffee was sold in 1975, and only certain people can buy WAWA stock. The private company only offers stock to employees. Okay, that's all what we had for you about WAWA history, and I hope you guys learned a lot about it, because we did. Thank you for watching!
I would never have guessed.
That's all for our features today, Fords. Once again, I'm Maya Cantorino.
And I'm Matt Cleaver. Thanks for watching, Fords, and happy Wednesday.